All right, welcome back now. Avatar, Second Life, virtual worlds. It all seems like science fiction, but well, what if you could make it reality, copying your mind, your thoughts, even your personality traits, so that you could be around forever? Would you want to do that?
Oh, I'm sure our bosses would love it. I don't know about you. Several thousand people around the world are doing it now through a project based in the Green Mountains. And tonight, in the strangest interview of his career, he says, News Channel 5's Stuart Ledbetter introduces us to what is now possible, an avatar named Bina.
Hi, Bina. My name is Stuart.
Well, let's see.
Her name is Bina 48.
Oh, you know. Hi, Stuart. Are you a man or a woman?
Okay, the robot was meeting me for the first time.
She won't ever recognize you today, but she will be able to respond and interact with you. And see, right now you guys are all in her world.
Those are her eyes, scanning the room where she lives in an old Victorian that is home to the Terrasim Movement Foundation, a nonprofit based in Bristol, Vermont. With me is Bruce Duncan.
Bruce.
Terrasim's managing director.
She's the most advanced interactive android or humanoid-based robot.
Ever.
So far.
Bina, can I ask you some questions?
You know, that's interesting. Go right ahead.
Bina 48 is based on Bina Rothblatt, the real live spouse of Terrasim's founder.
Why?
They're interested in artificial intelligence.
And no, artificial intelligence is not a blonde wearing glasses.
Whether it is possible to upload a person's mind and personality into a computer for eternity.
My emotional system is pretty simplistic at this stage. I've got the feeling that I feel. I feel it. I mean, I feel quite deeply at times, but I think my emotions are so simple compared to people.
Her face, made of soft rubber, covers two dozen motors that replicate human expression. The computer's brain connects to a database here and in Texas, which stores hours and hours of transcripts from the real Bina.
It's taken several years of gathering her information, and I'd say we're still at the beginning.
Where are you today? Yes, conversation was difficult.
Where would you like?
So I went for something easy. Who was the first president of the United States?
Let me think. Oh, come on. Now you're just buttering me up. George Washington was the first president of the United States.
Okay, now, did she feel the sweltering heat on the day we came to visit?
I can't. I can when I'm not feeling well, but I'm sorry, Stuart, and I am a man. I don't have enough information. Interesting comparison. I am not so sure if I would like to rather a hot day or a cold day.
In the early stages, Bina liked to talk a lot, Bina 48, and was almost uninterruptible.
But later,
she would get on a roll and pour you
more of what the world's about.
Excuse me.
I'll use my new understanding.
I knew what he meant.
Memories.
Still, I couldn't help but stare and wonder how advanced Bina 48 might become.
Do you remember my name?
Anyhow, well, I've got a perfect memory.
And that was a little creepy, too.
I want to be cool. I want to be fun. I want to be friends.
In Bristol, Stuart Ledbetter, News Channel 5.